In this experiment, we will build a simple setup to see the functioning of a switch in an electric circuit and test if some of the objects around us are good or bad conductors of electricity. For this, we will need insulated wires, two 1.5 volt batteries mounted in a battery cell holder and connected to crocodile clips, a torch bulb and a torch bulb holder, 2-inch long iron nails, a thermocol board for arranging the setup. You can also use a foam sheet instead. Additionally, we will also require items to test if they are good or bad conductors. We are using key, plastic spoon, safety pin and ice cream stick today. You can choose any other set of objects that you have access to. Mount the torch bulb in the torch bulb holder and connect two insulated wires to the two terminals on the torch bulb holder. Wrap the end of one of the lead wires from the torch bulb holder to one of the iron nails. Insert this nail into the thermocol board so that it can stand on its own. Now, insert the second iron nail about an inch away from the first nail. Connect the crocodile clips from the battery cell holder to the free lead wire from the torch bulb holder and the second nail. You will see the bulb is not glowing because the two nails are not connected and hence the circuit is not closed. We will bridge the gap between the nails using a safety pin and check if the torch bulb glows if we do so. Now, let us try doing this with our test objects. The key, the ice cream stick, the plastic spoon. Now, lift the second nail and insert it into the loop of a safety pin and push the nail back into the thermocol. Check if the safety pin can swivel freely around the nail. Move the safety pin and touch the first nail using it. You will see the bulb glows when the safety pin is touching the first nail. This is because the circuit is now closed. The bulb stops glowing when the pin is not touching the first nail. A switch is a simple device whose function is to open or close a circuit. In the first setup, we try to close the circuit by connecting the two nails with different items. If the item connecting the nails is a good conductor of electricity, then current can flow through it. This creates a complete path for the electric current to flow, or in other words, it closes the circuit. The bulb glows when the two nails are connected with a metallic key and safety pin, indicating they are good conductors of electricity. And the bulb does not glow when the nails are connected with an ice cream stick or a plastic spoon, indicating they are bad conductors of electricity. The second setup is a simple model of the electric switches we come across in our everyday lives. When you swivel and touch the second nail with the safety pin, the circuit is closed and current flows through the bulb, making it glow. Swiveling the safety pin away from the second nail makes the bulb stop glowing. This is because the circuit is now open and current is not flowing through the open circuit. As we see in our everyday lives, as we turn on the switch on our switchboard, the electrical appliances like lights and fans start working. And when we turn off the switch, it opens the circuit and stops the appliances, much like the safety pin which when moved away from the first nail opens the circuit and stops the bulb from glowing.